Well, it's good to be back in the house of the Lord this morning. I'd like to tell you this morning that the devil has really been busy in my life. Anyway, he's worried far out of me all week. Mm-hmm. And all I can do is just say, Lord, you take care of everything.
Right.
In the book of Romans, we'll be studying some in the 5th chapter. We was in the 3rd chapter last Sunday. We'll study just a little bit in the 5th chapter of Romans this morning. A very good, fruitful chapter. One that has really got a lot of substance in it that's good for us if we take it and we chew on it real good, as old pastor I used to know of said, just to chew it, keep on chewing it, and then chew it some more. And every time you chew it, you'll get a little bit more out of it. But he says in verse 1 of chapter 5 of the book of Romans, therefore being justified by faith. Now, I want you to know what he's saying here when he says justified. He's saying that you are just. You're conformed to the truth. And that you know about the remissions of sin.
Amen.
And that you're not guilty.
Mm.
Now, that to me is the most thing. I'm not guilty.
Amen.
I'm not guilty anymore of a sin that will send me to hell. I may be guilty of a lot of things, but that's one sin that's been taken away by the blood of Jesus Christ on the cross of Calvary. And I'm not guilty of it.
Amen.
And so, this morning, he's saying, therefore, being justified by faith. And you need this morning to know about what faith is. Faith is accepting it as it is. And that what we said here about being justified, you know this morning that when you were saved, that you were justified before God by Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ is sitting on the throne beside the Father, making intercessions for us. And when anything comes up that the devil wants to present to God against us, and he will, and he mm-hmm. does, and he aggravates you, and he creates problems for you, and he offers you solutions that is not pleasing to the Lord. And then he takes that and he presents it to God. And
right.
Jesus is there and saying, hey, they're my children. They're justified. They're not guilty. And so that's what the writer here, Paul, was speaking about here when he said, therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace.
Amen.
Now, this thing of peace, I want to read you a little something that I found over in the book of John in chapter 14, I believe it is. And I will read it to you this morning. I believe it. Maybe you probably read it, and you probably see it time and time again. But maybe it'll just come a little bit different. And this might be another chewing that I was talking about, that you'll get a little bit more juice out of it. But in chapter 14, in verse 27, I think 23. Let's look at 23. 14:23. Jesus answered, and this is what Judas Iscariot said unto him, Lord, how is it that thou wilt manifest thyself unto us and not unto the world? How will you show yourself to us? Listen, it's by faith this morning. Remember what we're looking at, this word faith. But he says here, Jesus answered and said unto him, if a man love me, he will keep my word.
Amen.
Now that's a good thought this morning, in that if you've got that desire in your heart to keep his word, then that's a good testimony for you that you've been justified by faith. But notice here, he says, if a man love me, he will keep my word, and my Father will love him. Now, again, this thing, when the devil comes to you and he starts a knocking and a banging and accusing you, remember what the word says here, and my Father will love you. Or love him, it says, and we will come to him and make our abode with him. And he says, and we, of course, he's talking about himself when he was here upon this earth. because he's talking about him and the Holy Spirit. And he says here, and we, him and the Holy Spirit, will come to him and make our abode with him. Now, we know that Jesus, when he left this world, he said, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I'll come again and receive you unto myself. And he says, and I will send the Comforter.
Amen.
And that Comforter this morning, you can check your Bible and read in it, but that Comforter is the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
And that Holy Ghost comes and takes up his abode within your body. He guides you, he speaks to your soul, and he tells you what that the will of the Lord is, and you, when you are in a condition where that you may sin or have a desire to sin or that are tempted, the Holy Spirit is the one that comes to you.
Amen.
And says, hey, you know, you better think on this, you better not do this, you better think twice about this. So he says here in this, he says, and we will come unto him and make our abode with him. He that loveth me not keepeth not my sayings. And
right.
So here again, you know, it talks about the judging the fruit, or a fruit judger, or seeing somebody, not judging, but recognizing them for what they stand for. Notice what he says here. And he says, and he that loveth me keepeth my saying, and the word which... Let me get back. And we will... He that loveth me... Here it is, verse 24. He that loveth me not... He that loveth me not keepeth not my sayings, and the word which ye hear is not mine. So the thing of it is, if you see people that are unbelievers, this is one of the ways that it can point you to the direction of realizing that there's something that is needful in their life.
Right.
And you can't say, well, he's not saved, or he is saved, because listen, the Bible tells us not to make that decision, because that's up to the Lord Jesus Christ and God. But here he says here that he will, and the word which ye hear is not mine, but the Father which sent me. These things have I spoken unto you, yet being present with you. But the Comforter, here it is, the Holy Ghost, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things.
Amen.
And bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. Now here's what I want to, because listen, I've had a trial with the devil this week, and he's been aggravating me, but listen, and I read this, and it's comforting. But here he says here, he said, I'm going to send the Holy Ghost.
Right.
He's in here, and listen, he says here that he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. So we see the word peace. He says, peace I leave with you. Now back in our lesson this morning, and I'm not, he says, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. Here he said here, the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance. Then in verse 27 he says, peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you, not as the world giveth. Now
right.
How does the world give you peace? It cannot give you peace to your soul.
Amen.
It's impossible for this world to give you peace to your soul. It can give you peace to this old flesh.
Mm-hmm.
It can do that, and that's what the flesh is so, gets so messed up with, and is so easy tempted by Satan, because Satan is still ruling my flesh to a certain degree. And listen, he knows how to tempt me with worldly possessions. And he knows this morning that the world has the things out there that this flesh desires.
Mm-hmm.
And it's money, and it's worldly possessions of all kinds. And listen, that's what my flesh, the biggest majority of the time, craves.
Mm-hmm.
It don't crave to serve the Lord.
Right.
And it's a sinful and it's a sorrowful thing, but that's the condition that I'm in, and that's the condition that we all are in.
You're right.
So we need to take this, and again, like I said, you need to chew on it, you need to chew on it, and you need to chew on it, because listen, the more you chew it, the sweeter it gets, and the
Amen.
Sweeter it gets, the better you understand it, and the more you yeah. love it. And you can, you'll be able to withstand the wiles of the devil when he comes to you. And so again, he says, peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you, not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your hearts be troubled. Very, very important this morning. Let not your hearts be troubled, because
Amen.
That's the thing that happens to so many people, is when the devil comes in and presents something and you fight it off. Well, the first thing you know, he's coming in at a different exit or a different route, and he's presenting the same thing to you, only it's in a different way. And you, this morning, and I need to understand and recognize that, and understand that our heart is not to be troubled.
Amen.
Because, listen, that's what causes this old flesh to get all upset, is that worldly thing sometimes upsets this flesh, and this flesh don't like it. And the thing of it is, then our spirit has to try to console the flesh, and it can't, to a certain extent. But the Holy Spirit is the only thing that can come in and comfort it. And sometimes it takes a lot of the Holy Spirit to do that.
Amen.
Our flesh is an unruly, ungodly thing.
Amen.
And it's just all the time there, and it's just all the time aggravating us. But he says here, in verse 28, ye have heard how I said unto you, I go away and come again unto you. If you love me, you would rejoice, because I said, I go unto the Father, for my Father is greater than I. And now I have told you before it comes to pass, that when it comes to pass, you might believe. Hereafter I will not talk much with you, for the prince of this world, the devil, cometh and hath nothing in me. So, but that the world may know that I love the Father.
Amen.
And as the Father gave me commandments, even so I do, arise and let us go hence. And so here again, back in our lesson in chapter 5 of the book of Romans, he says here, therefore being justified by faith, we have peace.
Amen.
Now, the words that I have read unto you this morning about this peace, you ought to understand, you ought to take hold of it. And I sent a sign over here on this church the other day about a problem, and he says, that says something about like, it's a whole lot harder to turn it loose than it is to hang on to it, or something of that degree. And listen, our flesh has problems of turning loose
right.
from things of this world. And so we as God's people need to put more confidence in his word, and more time in communicating with the Lord, because when we have these times, we need to get with ourselves and we need to talk to God about this thing.
Mm-hmm.
And Jesus Christ is there on the right hand of the Father.
You're right.
And he's the one that we pray to, and then he takes it to the Father and he presents it, and the Father can take care of the situation. And so this is a very important thing this morning. Now notice in verse 2, by whom also we have access by faith into this grace wherein we stand and rejoice in hope of the glory of God. Now I notice this word, by whom also we have access. Now, when you go today and go home, a lot of us will take a key when we get to the door, and we'll turn it and we'll go in. That's access.
Mm-hmm.
And he says here, we have access by faith. Now, that's talking about this morning, our faith towards God. We have an access this morning by faith, not by works, not by anything that we've done, but by faith, the faith that we're saved by, the grace that we're saved by. We have that faith to the Father through Jesus Christ our Lord. And when we need that access, all we need to do is go and place that key in that lock and go in by grace.
Amen.
We have access to the Father. And we can pray to the Lord Jesus Christ. And he's always there. He said, I'll never leave you and I'll never forsake you. So he's always there. And you can come into his presence and present your problem to him. Because listen, this is the problem that I've had this week, is that the devil is wearing the fur out of me.
Mm-hmm.
He's continually bringing things to my mind that I don't care anything about listening to.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's the thing that I just have to go back and say, hey, he's worrying me. He's bothering me. Would you please remove him from me for a while? And sometimes it happens and sometimes it don't. But the thing of it is, when he don't, I give God the glory because, listen, the devil had to go and get permission from God
right.
to come and worry me because I'm his child. And so by that, I obtained some patience through this thing. And so he's saying here, by whom also we have access by faith into this grace. And that grace is by grace are you saved through faith, and that not of yourself. This is the grace that he's talking about here. By whom also we have access by faith into this grace, wherein we stand and rejoice in hope. Now, it's not that we stand up and say, oh, praise the Lord, I hope that I'll make it. Mm-hmm. It's not that kind of a hope. But it is that blessed assurance this morning that when Jesus Christ died on the cross and when God said, you're justified, you're not guilty, we have that blessed hope
mm-hmm.
that one day we'll be out of this turmoil.
Amen.
One day we'll be away from all of this agony and all of this hurt and all these things, and we'll be in the presence of the Lord.
Amen.
And you know, I thought the other day about why I sometimes pray, Father, give me good health and give me strength and all this. And if I knew exactly what was waiting on the other side of the Jordan, listen, I wouldn't be praying that prayer.
Right.
I wouldn't be praying that prayer because, listen, this thing down here, it ain't nothing but a bunch of aggravation.
Amen.
But listen, I know in my soul, and I have faith that one day I'm going to enjoy that. But this flesh cannot turn loose. And this flesh wants to stay here if it's 106 years and die with cancer. That's the way he wants it. But listen, I would be much better off to say, Father, thy will be done.
Mm-hmm.
And
amen.
So, you know, that's the thing. So here, he says here, wherein, in verse 2, the bottom part, we stand and rejoice in this blessed hope of our Savior Jesus Christ, of the glory of God. Now, and not only so, but we glory in tribulations. And the tribulations are so many things that comes to pass in our lives. We have tribulations on every hand. And we sometimes thank the Lord and say, thank you, Lord, for this, and thank you, Lord, for that. And we don't know, we don't have no inkling of idea of how many tribulations he has pushed out of our way as we went down this path. Because listen, they're there on every side. And listen, the devil, he's laying them in our path, just like over here in these countries where they lay those bombs in the onion row and things. He's laying them there wanting us to step on them and blow us up or to keep us from serving the Lord.
Right.
He's there. And so here, he says here, knowing that tribulations worketh patience. And so these tribulations, and like I spoke of a while ago, sometimes You know, sometimes the Lord answers, and sometimes He doesn't at the time that you ask. And I was thinking about a certain person in the Bible that was, I'm trying to think of his name, was going to present his son, and he had the nitrile. Listen, he was going to kill him.
Mm-hmm.
But listen, the Lord let him go just as far as He wanted him to go. And that sometimes that's me, and sometimes that's you.
Amen.
Sometimes you don't get that answer when you pray. And listen, sometimes it takes a little bit getting closer to the fire and feeling the heat before, hey, He draws it and opens it up and lets you walk on through. But don't get impatient with God.
Amen.
Don't give up on God. Don't say, hey, He's forsaken me, and He said He'd always be with me. Listen, you haven't seen the end.
Amen.
You haven't seen the end of your life. You haven't seen the end of the problem that you're having right now. You've not seen the end of it, or it wouldn't be a problem. And so just keep on keeping on and keep on chewing on that thing. And listen, you'll find out that it gets sweeter as the days go by. Listen, now, He says here, knowing that tribulations work with patience, and patience experience, and experience hope. Now here we come back to this hope again. Listen, we go through these tribulations and we go through all of these temptations and all of this, but it strengthens you.
Amen.
If you will just hang on, listen, you'll get a blessing. If you're serving the Lord, and if you hold on to serving the Lord, listen, you'll get that experience, and you'll get that blessed hope. You'll have that hope within you, people, and you'll be a better person. And you say, well, it'll all be over. No, it won't be over with, because listen, there's another one coming. Just as long as you live here, you're going to face some of these problems.
Right.
You're going to have
Amen.
Them. You're going to have them. But the thing of it is, you'll be a little bit more prepared to face the next one. And you'll remember this one back here that you went through. Well, you know, it was like this and it was like this, but it all got took care of. And so if you've got problems this morning, if you're going through problems, listen, just hang on.
Amen.
Because one day you'll go through it, and one day all will be good. So again, we want to read a little bit more in verse 5. And hope maketh not ashamed. And I want to turn over to Romans. I believe it's Romans 16 or Romans. I believe it's Romans 16. I think I might have one. I'll read something other day. Romans 1. Turn back the other way. Romans 1:16. I have it over there. All right. Now, Paul writing to the church at Rome there, and he says, "For I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation."
Amen.
"To everyone that believeth, to the Jew first and also to the Greek. For therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith, that is written, the just shall live by faith."
Mm-hmm.
And we've already spoken on this faith, but here I want you to see something here. He says in verse 5 of our lesson, "And hope maketh not ashamed, because the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Spirit, which is given unto us. For when we were yet without strength," talking about before salvation, before we had Jesus Christ, even, he says, "For when we were yet without strength, in due time, Christ died for the ungodly."
Amen.
And so he went to the cross and he died for us. And this is why that we should have this blessed hope. And the writer over here in this says, "I'm not ashamed of the gospel. And I'm not ashamed this morning to, and I mean, you say, well, it's easy to say here, but listen, when you go out into the world and you see these people that have an adder's tongue and they want to bite and defile you, and listen, you ought to be able to stand up and say, I'm not ashamed of the gospel.
Amen.
Of the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm not ashamed to tell you that he died on the cross of Calvary for me. And I'm not ashamed this morning. And the writer here says here in verse 16 that I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God.
Amen.
And unto salvation to everyone that believeth. So if you believe that this morning that Jesus Christ died on the cross of Calvary for you, shed his blood to make an atonement for your sins, and Jesus and God foreordained you before the world was, and he called you at a certain time in your life. Listen, that says to you this morning, you're justified. You're not guilty. You're not guilty of the sin of death. No, it's not even considered, because you have been saved, and that sin debt that was paid was covered by the blood of Jesus Christ. And when God looks upon Jesus Christ, he sees the blood.
Amen.
He cannot see that sin that you were accused of or that you inherited. It's there, it's covered. It's no more there. And so you're not guilty of it. And you can say, devil, get away.
Amen.
Because listen, I know that you had to get permission from God. Listen to this. I know that you had to get permission from God. You had to go before him and kneel and ask him permission to come down here and air with me. And listen, people, that will turn that old booger. He despises to hear things like that.
Mm-hmm.
He don't want to hear it, because listen, he knows one day that he's going to be cast into that lake of fire.
Right.
And he's going to be there for eternity.
Amen.
And he's not going to be able to come back like he does out of hell and worry the people no more. He is through with him, and he knows it. And every time that he gets an opportunity to aggravate you, he will. And listen, to hear God's word, it just makes him like a wasp. He gets madder and madder and madder. And that's what we have to deal with here upon this earth. But be assured of this, that you have your Father, the God of heaven, and your brother, Jesus Christ, to go to God and say, hey, I made that atonement. My blood has covered them, and they're not guilty.
Amen.
And so the devil can tell you what he wants to about your condition. But listen, when you do, you can say, devil, get thee behind me. And you know, as he tempted Jesus, and you know, I've heard it said, if he tempted Jesus, what do you think he'll do for you? He'll tempt you too. But Jesus used what? The word.
Amen.
The word. The sword. And he left him for a while.
Mm-hmm.
For a while.
That's it.
Listen, he'll be back after you.
Mm-hmm.
And he'll be back after me. And all I can do is say, Lord, it's your problem, and I can't handle it. There's no way I can handle it, because I'm not equipped. I've not got anything this morning that will hinder the devil.
Mm.
It's him. So again here, I want you to see something here this morning. For when we were yet without strength, and I didn't read it, for scarcely for a righteous man will one die. Yet peradventure for a good man, some would even dare to die. But God commended his love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
Amen.
And that is those that he chose before the world began. That's the ones that he, when they come to this earth, he drawed them, he called them, and they're his.
Amen.
And that's the ones that Jesus Christ died for. Now, if you're one of his, you're safe in his arms. I'm not saying that there won't be any problems or heartaches or anything like that. But if you're not, then you're fair game to the devil.
Right.
And if your soul has not been covered by the blood of Jesus Christ, listen, you're still a candidate for hell. That's it. And so here he says, but much more than being now justified by his blood, we shall be saved from the wrath through him. And so the wrath of dying and going to hell, we're going to be saved. And through this wrath, I don't know if he's talking about what all it includes, but it's punishment. And so he says, for if, in verse 10, I'm reading this book, for if when we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of his son, much more being reconciled, we shall be saved by his life.
Amen.
So this morning, I say to you this morning, we're soldiers. We are, but we just got to keep on. We just got to keep on in the battle. And you know, there's angels standing around us.
Amen.
And it's a short time, and we'll be through with it, and we'll be going home. So we thank you this morning, and hope that this will kind of encourage you, and hope that you that the devil has been aggravating and trying to do his best to convince you of something that you're not. I hope this will encourage you, because this is God's word and what it says, and it's true. And we know that the devil is as a roaring lion, what the Bible says, seeking whom he may devour. And if he can't change your birth now that you've been saved, he'll aggravate the devil out of you. And so that's our lesson for today. I hope that it's been a blessing. Thank you all for listening.
Amen.